All right, welcome back. This segment is going to be on best watering practices. By the time we finally get around to planting these trees and we mulch them and we stake them and give them stem protection, the most important thing that we can do is keep them well hydrated. And there are two ways of looking at watering trees. One is, how much water do you give each time you do water? And the second is, all right, how often do I have to water? So we're going to talk about that first of all. So first of all, the dose. And if it's a calipered tree, so a caliper is the stem diameter measured about 6 to 12 inches off the ground. For each inch of stem caliper, you need, you can be generous, put down a couple gallons of water. So if you're planting a 2-inch caliper tree or 1¾-inch caliper tree, which those are the most common sizes for nice looking landscape trees, you only need to put down about 4, you know, you can slap on 5 gallons if you want to each time. So that's your dose, is 4, maybe 5 gallons. That's all it really needs. It's also critical to put the water where the roots are. Don't just like dump it in the direction of the tree. You know, you planted that tree, you know where the roots are. Pour that water over the root system, or somehow get the water over the root system. So that's your dose. Next is frequency. And you're not going to like this one, but the frequency is actually more critical than the dose. So you can't go, you can't plant a tree and go off on a 1-month vacation thinking, oh, it's probably going to rain while I'm gone and everything will be fine. No, you have to make sure your neighbors know that these trees need to be watered 2 to 3 times a week. From the day you plant it all through the growing season, and that growing season extends into the autumn, because the roots are still growing, extends into the autumn. So as long as that ground's not frozen, you are watering. Why is there this range of 2 to 3 times? Depends on your soil. Actually, it could be 1 to 3 times in some cases. If you have a soil that really holds the moisture, you might be able to get by with watering once a week. Might be able to. If you have a wicked sandy soil, the percolation rate is like flushing a toilet, you're going to have to water a minimum probably of 3 times a week. And just keep that up. Water is cheap. Whether you're on a well or if you're in a city water system, it is cheap. So don't kill your tree by not watering it enough, or conversely watering it too much if it's poor percolation rate. So that's your dose, that's your frequency. This is research-based information. Cornell University published this years and years and years ago, as did University of Florida. So heed their advice and you'll keep your trees good and healthy. Now, maybe you don't want to run out every time, or maybe you do want to run out and touch your tree and get close to it. So I'm going to take you through a range of watering devices, from the simplest to the most interesting. So the simplest, get a bucket of water. This is 5 gallons. Fill it, or almost fill it. Don't fill it to the top because your pants are going to get wet then, and your shoes too. Take it out and slowly pour it over the root system. Or you can drag your hose out and do it too. It's a lot easier, especially if the tree is a little bit far away from the house. It's a lot easier just to bucket it out rather than drag the hose out every time. The next thing you could do if you wanted to is get a better looking bucket. For one thing, you do not have to use old, white, ugly buckets. You can get nice looking 5-gallon buckets. Drill about 5 holes, 3/8-inch diameter, about the size, stick a small finger in. 5 holes in the bottom, and not 4, not 6, it's got to be 5 holes. Drill those in the bottom. Place this at the base of the tree, right where the root systems are, and then get another bucket and bring over 5 gallons of water and pour it in here, and it slowly then allows the water to seep out into the planting hole. This works really well, especially if you are planting on a little bit of a slope where the water tends to kind of sheet and run off, or if the soil is a little bit more compacted, hard, and it doesn't, you know, percolate nice and slowly down to the root system. This is kind of a nice, simple way. These buckets are cheap. Drill bits are cheap. Drills are more expensive, but this works. Okay, you have a little bit more money to spend. Soaker hoses. You do not have to get 50-foot soaker hoses. They have modified soaker hoses that are basically a ring with about a 2-foot diameter. You can make it shorter than that, that goes around the tree, connects together. You hook your garden hose up to it, and then you just hook it up and let the water seep down into the soil. Nice and easy peasy, doesn't run off. One problem with this, takes a while to figure out how long you have to leave the hose running to get that dose where you wanted it. How long is it going to take to run that hose to make sure you get 2, 4, 5 gallons of water that percolates down in there? So the easy way of doing that is just hook up your little system, put it in a big tub, turn on the water, see how long it takes to bring that water level up to 4 or 5 gallons or whatever you're putting down, and just remember that, and then it works. So soaker hoses are real inexpensive and very easy task to do. Next one. I actually really like this one. Again, it's high impact plastic. This is 4.5 gallons of water. Here's the little port. You can just stick the hose down in here, fill it up with water, close it up so critters don't go in there, and bees will get in there too. On the bottom, you'll see the little holes, and there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 holes. Remember, 5 holes. If you want to increase it, you can drill in these little dimples and make more holes if you want to. I really like these. I've had these out in the field for years. Sunlight doesn't break them down. Critters don't chew into them. Even if they have a little bit of water left in them, which I don't know why they would, when it freezes, I've had no problems with it cracking the plastic or anything. So I highly recommend these. A little bit more expensive than what we've talked about. Still, very, very reasonable, and it's a drop in the bucket compared to what you paid for that tree and the time you put in on planting it too. The other nice thing about this is if you don't like the way this looks, you can just cover it with mulch, especially to the outside. You don't fill the inside with mulch because you'd be over mulching the tree, but you can put mulch over the top and then to the outside, and from a distance you can't even tell this is in the landscape. So that's one of the nice things about this one. Our next option are water bags. Sometimes they're called water bladders. That's kind of an uncomfortable name for me. So I think that a water bag is probably the most common term for these things. And I'm sure that you've seen these before. Gotta make sure you don't see the manufacturer on this, no product placement in these videos. These hold 20 gallons of water and they zip. So they zip close like this. You can actually zip 2 or 3 of these things together and put on 40 or 80 or 100. You can just keep zipping these things together and just keep building up the volume of water you're putting down if they're really, really big trees. There's a little port in here right under the label. Almost. This is where you place the hose and fill it up. This can accommodate a 2-inch diameter hose. So if you're a municipality looking at this video, that's a fairly common size of hose for a water truck, 2-inch diameter. Put it in there, fill it up. Again, there are little holes in the bottom. I actually think there may be more than 5, but I haven't counted them. And it slowly seeps out. I think the first time I used these, somebody said, oh yeah, it takes like 12 hours for it to completely seep out. That's not true. It seeps out faster than that. The nice thing about it though is it keeps the water from running out. Just it's a nice slow percolation. Plus, if you can imagine me being a tree, wrapping this around me, this is a little bit of a stem protection. Now, again, it's going to keep chemicals from drifting and hitting the trunk. It'll probably keep your spouse from running into it with a lawnmower or a string trimmer. So it actually does give some stem protection. That's a good part. The bad part is no sunlight is reaching my belly or my tree trunk, and so it can't photosynthesize normally. So I don't normally think of these beyond that first growing season to get the plants established. And by the way, if you don't like the way these look, like this color, there are different colors. This one's kind of a, if I wasn't a guy, I would probably know what exact color this is. I call this kind of greenish blue. You can get these in black. So you don't have to have the green. If you don't like looking at these things, some people think they look like garbage bags wrapped around the tree trunk. You can, these are the ones that they really do call bladders. They are essentially a modification of this, except that it's a bag. So it's low to the ground, still holds 20 gallons. And when you lay it around the tree, it's flat. When you fill it up, it looks like a big bladder, water bladder. And again, it slowly percolates away. Those are the ones that people use for evergreens. You can't use these big bags on evergreens because they have branches that go all the way down to the ground. So the shorter, right to the ground bladders are the ones to use for that. So again, you can go online and get those. There are a lot, most of your garden centers carry these things too. All right. Now, this is called a water well. And if you can imagine, this is going to be sunk down into the ground. These little teeth on here or whatever, just press it down into the ground, kind of wiggle it in, and then you can fill this up with water, and then it slowly percolates. So this will hold a good 6 inches of water. Now I have had people say, well, isn't that bad for the tree trunk? Won't that make it rot with that water standing in there? It's like, that's not what's going to kill the tree. If water is standing in there, that means your soil isn't percolating 24 inches in 24 hours. That's going to kill the tree, not the water standing around the trunk. So this is more expensive. These do come in different colors too. I've seen them in brown also. A little bit of physical protection from the spouse. Again, lawnmower, string trimmer, you know the routine by now. The hard part is getting these over the tree when you plant them. You have to cut off a lot of branches. Oh wait, never mind. You don't have to do that. It opens up like this. Then you can just put it right around the trunk and it slides right back in place. So this is called a water well. As we've been going up in different products, we've been going up in cost too. So this is the second most expensive one I'm going to show you. But a lot of people like these. They work well. Get it? They work well. Water well. Finally, and I usually don't, I don't like product placement, but I just like saying the name of this one. This is called the tree diaper. And I know a lot of municipalities are using these because they do, believe it or not, get, some people complain about everything. They get complaints from their constituents in the community when the boulevard trees have these water bags, and they'll complain that they look like garbage bags and they don't like the way they look. Well, in comes the tree diaper. And the way these things work is you put them in a bucket of water, or a bucket like this, fill it up with water, and it takes 15-20 minutes, because those are little beads that hold water, moisture in there, and they kind of swell up. So they're like gels. It's kind of like, you know, the 2-week diapers that they have for kids now. So they'll swell up and they'll hold that moisture, and then it slowly kind of leaves the bag, because you're putting this right on the soil, and it goes into the soil over the root system, so it maintains. So it's a little bit of a mulch, and it's also a little bit of a slow release of moisture. And every time it rains, they kind of rehydrate and it gets bigger again, or you have to come around with a hose and water it in. Now, the reason why a lot of municipalities like these is they can plant the trees, they can hydrate these things, they put them around the trees, cover it with mulch. Now, all the people that have been complaining about the water bags and everything else, all they see is mulch. They don't see the watering device. So even though this is the most expensive, for some communities, they like these because it cuts down on the complaints from their constituents, and it works pretty well. So that's kind of the range of the watering devices. We've gone over the dose, the frequency, all the different ways of getting the water to the trees. And water is the silver bullet. Really is the silver bullet for making sure your trees make it through the first year, get established, and live for more than 5 or 6 years. That's it, folks. See you next time.